Mixing techniques in baking.
Good day to everyone watching this. This is Miss Joyce, and I'm here to discuss and demonstrate the different mixing techniques as well as the tools that you can use for each mixing technique for bread and pastry production.
Mixing is a method that is done to evenly distribute and to combine the ingredients together to create a mixture. Importance of mixing: to distribute the ingredients properly, to break down fats and mix this with liquids, activates the formation of gluten from flour, and incorporate air into the mixture. Each mixing method gives different texture and character to the baked product, so it is important to pay close attention to the mixing methods so you could attain your desired results. Tools for mixing: hand mixer, rubber spatula, whisk, wooden spoon, pastry blender, sifter or strainer. Mixing techniques: 1. Sifting, 2. Kneading, 3. Cut in or cutting in, 4. Beating, 5. Stirring, 6. Creaming, 7. Whipping, 8. Cut and fold, 9. Folding, 10. Blending, 11. Binding. Sifting: tool needed, strainer or sifter. Sifting: separating coarse particles of dry ingredients like flour and sugar using a strainer. It breaks up lumps in dry ingredients and aerates them. Kneading: tools needed, you can use electric stand mixer or dough mixer, or we can do this by hand. Kneading: the action used to manipulate bread dough that forms the gluten network in dough. Well-developed gluten allows the dough to stretch and expand as it rises. Cut in or cutting in. Tools needed, we can use bench scraper or a pastry blender or a food processor. Cut in or cutting in, to distribute solid fat in dry ingredients. It is recommended to use cold butter and cut into the flour until you form little lumps of butter. Aside from pastry blender, we can also use alternative tools like forks, knives, or even our fingers. Just rub the butter lightly on the flour until the flour is lumpy like this. Beating: tools needed, we can use whisk or egg beater or hand mixer. In beating, the ingredients are moved vigorously in a back and forth, up and down and around motion until they are smooth. Stirring: tool needed, wooden spoon. Stirring is the simplest method of combining all the ingredients in a circular motion using a wooden spoon. Creaming: tools needed, we can use wooden spoon or hand mixer. Creaming. Fat and sugar are beaten together until the mixture becomes fluffy, airy, and lighter in color. Whipping. Tools needed: whisk or hand mixer. Whipping. Air is incorporated into foods like egg whites and whipping cream through a vigorous mixing. We do this so that we can produce light, fluffy texture and add volume to the finished product. Pot and fold. Tool needed: rubber spatula. Cut and fold method is usually done when combining one light and one heavy mixture like the whipped egg whites and this chocolate mixture. To do this, cut vertically into the mixture and turn often by gently sliding the rubber spatula across the bottom of the mixing bowl. Folding. Tool needed: rubber spatula. Folding is also done when we need to combine light and heavy mixtures together. Using a rubber spatula or a whisk, gently fold the mixture to maintain its volume. Blending. Tools needed: whisk or wooden spoon or hand mixer. Blending. In blending, the ingredients are mixed thoroughly so they become one. Binding. Tools needed: wooden spoon or hand mixer. Binding. Adding a liquid such as beaten egg or melted fat to a dry mixture to hold it together. Just mold and press gently the mixture into a container.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video. Bye!